Hello everyone, this is teacher Varsha, your history teacher. I welcome you all for the first online class of history. Last week we have learnt about lesson 4, History of India Art. Today we are going to learn about lesson 5, Mass Media and History. Now in this lesson we are going to deal with the following topics: Introduction to Mass Media, History of Mass Media, Why do we need Mass Media, Critical Understanding of the Information received through mass media and professional opportunities. Now, if we see about this blue box here, what could be the method of sending news to Delhi if there was a famine in Bihar in the Mughal period? How much time would it take for the aid to reach Bihar after the Badshah heard the news? Now, this is when the Mughals were ruling India. Now, here the aid, meaning of aid means help. If any disaster has taken place, the king was responsible to help his people. So, now the distance between Delhi and Bihar is not near. It is more than 1,000 kilometers. So, how much time it will take to reach Bihar? Naturally, it will take more than 10 days, more than 15 days, depending upon the mode of transport. Now, during those days, the horses were used as transport. Elephants were used, so we cannot exactly tell how many days the help will be reaching the people. Let us go to the next topic, introduction to mass media. Mass media contains two words. Mass, in this context, means an aggregation of people. So what is the meaning of aggregation? Aggregation means a group of people. Aggregation means a group of people. Media. Media means various modes of communication. Media means various modes of communication. For example, we have newspapers, television, radio, mobiles. Thus, mass media is a field of mass communication. We can easily send some information to a faraway destination through a medium of communication. In the olden days, a crier would run in the streets beating drums and crying out important news according to the orders of the king. The news would spread among people by word of mouth. Now, this is in the olden days. Now, we must have seen in the movies, the king, if he wants to give any news, a person was appointed, a person was sent with a big drum. He used to run in the streets and he used to beat the drum and people used to gather around. And then he used to give the news whatever the king had told him. And from this, the people used to spread the news, telling one another. In Marathi we say Davandi Pitavnara. In Hindi we say Dandora Pitnevala. The next is history of mass media. Printing technology and newspapers were introduced in India after the arrival of the British. When the British arrived in India, they started with the printing press. And from that time we got to get the newspapers and the books. And people were able to read the newspapers and read the books. People started receiving printed news through newspapers. Newspapers became the first mass medium of circulating information and knowledge among people. The next is newspapers. Newspapers. Newspaper is a publication which mainly prints news, editorials, people's opinions, entertaining or other supplementary content. It is printed and distributed regularly at a defined time. Newspapers provide various local, national and international news. Newspapers are historical documents which record current events. Many of us, we have newspapers in our house. If you open the newspaper, you will see different types of news. We have local news, we have national news, international news, sports news. Then editorial column is there in the newspaper. Now, what is the meaning of this editorial column? Editorial column means an article written by the editor expressing his opinion on a subject of a particular interest at the present. The next topic is precursors of newspapers. Now, what is the meaning of precursors? Precursors means something that happened or existed before another thing, especially if it either developed into it or had an influence on it. Now, for example, sulfur dioxide is the main precursor of acid rain. Before the beginning of the Common Era, there was a custom in Egypt of placing inscriptions with royal decrees at public place. Now, what is the meaning of inscriptions? An inscription is a carving on a stone or a wall. For example, the inscriptions found in the Brihadeshwara temple premises in Tanjavur. Many inscriptions of the period of Chalukya, Rashtrakuta, Chola and Yadav kings have been found. An inscription is considered to be a very important and reliable source of history. It helps us to understand features like the language, script, social life of a period. Inscriptions carved on sheets of copper are known as copper plates. Royal edicts, verdicts, etc. are inscribed on copper plates. Next, Emperor Ashoka also resorted to similar method to reach out to his subjects. In the Roman Empire, royal decrees were written on papers and those were distributed in all regions. They also contained the information of various events taking place in the nation and its capital. During Julius Caesar's regime, newspapers known as Acta Diurna, meaning acts of every day, used to be placed at public places in Rome. Now, to tell you about Julius Caesar. Julius Caesar was a renowned general, politician and scholar in ancient Rome who conquered the vast region of Gaul and helped initiate the end of the Roman Republic when he became dictator of the Roman Empire. Despite his brilliant military prowess, his political skills and his popularity with Rome's lower and middle class, his rule was cut short when opponents threatened by his rising power brutally assassinated him. Over the centuries, many of his words have become famous quotes such as, "I came, I saw, I conquered." It was a very effective way of conveying royal commands to people. In the 7th century CE, CE means Common Era, royal dictates were distributed among people at public places. In England, handouts used to be distributed occasionally, giving information about wars or important events. Travelers arriving from far away would add spice to stories from those places and narrate it to local people. Now, what is the meaning of this? Add spice. Add spice means to put more masala and tell about that particular story or giving information. The ambassadors of a king posted at various places would send back important news to the royal court. Now, what is the meaning of ambassador? Ambassador is an important official appointed by one's country or government to represent it in another country. The next is Bengal Gazette. The first English newspaper of India was printed on 29 January 1780. It was named as Calcutta General Advertiser or Bengal Gazette. It was started by James Augustus Hickey, an Irish gentleman. Darpan. The newspaper Darpan was started in 1832 in Mumbai. Now, this is the name given to the newspaper. How we have, this is in Marathi. So, Marathi newspapers which we read, Sakal newspaper is there, Lokmat is there, Navakal is there, Lok Satta is there. Bal Shastri Zambekar was the editor of Darpan. The next, make a list of national leaders in the pre-independence period and the newspapers started by then. So I want all of you to write this in your notebook. Make a list of national leaders in the pre-independence period. Pre-independence period means before independence. And the newspapers started by then. The news printed in Darpan can be reviewed to know about the political, economic, social and cultural events of those times. Here are a few new titles as example. The first one, the accounts of the expenditure from the three administrative divisions of the East India Company. Now, which are the three administrative divisions of the East India Company? They are Calcutta, Bombay and Chennai. These are the three divisions, Calcutta, Bombay and Chennai. The expenditure and the account of these three divisions was looked after. The next is the danger of Russian attack on the nation. The danger of Russia attacking India. Third one, appointment of a committee for cleanliness of the city. The fourth one, remarriage of Hindu widows. Remarriage of Hindu widows. The next, the inception of theatre at Calcutta. The inception of theatre at Calcutta. Now, what is the meaning of inception? The meaning of inception is the establishment or starting point of an institution or activity. The next one is achievements of Rajaram Mohan Roy in England. Reporting of such news throws light on various historical events of those times. Now, Rajaram Mohan Roy. Rajaram Mohan Roy was an Indian religious, social and educational reformer who was one of the founders of the Brahmo Samaj, a social religious reform movement in the Indian subcontinent. He was given the title of Raja by Akbar II, the Mughal Emperor. He is also known as the father of modern India. He attacked the custom of Sati. Sati means the ritual burning of widows upon the funeral pyres of their deceased husbands. The next is Prabhakar. This newspaper was started by Bhau Mahajan. The History of French Revolution and Shatapatri. The History of French Revolution and Shatapatri. The letters by Lokhitwadi. The name is Gopal Hari Deshmukh and Lokhitwadi. The people gave him this name, Lokhitwadi. Aimed at creating social awareness were published in this newspaper. The next is Nanoday. Nanoday printed the map of Asia in 1842 and the map of Europe in 1851. The honor of printing an illustration in an Indian newspaper for the first time goes to Nanoday. The news of installation of telegraph used for electrically transmitting a news can be seen in Nanoday. The news of the starting of railways in India was printed in Nanoday under the title Chakya Masoba, meaning Masoba with Wheels. It had also printed the news of the Indian War of Independence of 1857. Newspapers in those times were a very important medium of creating social awareness. A newspaper named Indu Prakash supported widow remarriage in a big way. Deen Bandhu, a newspaper representing the masses of the Indian society. Bahujan Samaj was started by Mahatma Jyotirao Phule's close associate Krishnalal Balekar. We get to know about the issues relating to the masses through this newspaper. Do you know? Bal Shastri Zambekar is referred to as the first editor by virtue of his being the editor of the first Marathi newspaper. His birth date, 6th January, is observed in Maharashtra as the Patrakar Din. Patrakar Din means Journalist Day. The next. Let each student in the class bring a cutting of interesting news. Create a journal from the collection of news. The next. Keshri and Maratha. Keshri and Maratha, the two newspapers, are indicative of an important stage in the history of Indian newspapers before independence. Gopal Ganesh Agarkar and Bal Gangadhar Tilak started these newspapers in 1881. They spoke about the social and political issues of that period. Keshri began to publish articles about the nationwide situations, books in the native languages and the politics in England. In the 21st century, newspapers have continued to fulfill an important role. It was acknowledged the fourth column of democracy. It was acknowledged as the fourth column of democracy. Magazines and journals. Magazines and journals are periodical publications, means after a certain period, after 15 days, after 10 days, After a week, the magazines and journals are published. This category includes publications which are weekly, bi-weekly, monthly, bi-monthly, quarterly, six-monthly, annual, etc. There may be some chronicles which are published at no fixed time. In recent times, many newspapers have introduced e-newspapers. The e-newspapers are being received well by the readers. Learn to read e-newspapers with the help of your teachers. Now, what is the meaning of e-newspapers? An online newspaper where we get to read printed news with the help of the internet on the mobile. An electronic newspaper is a self-contained, reusable and refreshable version of a traditional newspaper. Bal Shastri Jambekar started the first monthly magazine in Marathi. It was named Dig Darshan. Among the periodicals, Pragati, now a defunct journal, was started in 1929 and edited by Trimbak Shankar Shezwalkar. He wrote regularly in this historiographical journal of Maharashtra's history and social movements. Currently, there are many periodicals devoted to Indian history. Marathi journals such as Bharatiya Itihas Ani Samskruti and Marathwada Itihas Parishat Patrika may be cited as examples. Let us search and find out. Apart from the journals cited above, there are many more journals related to research in history published in Marathi, Hindi and English by various institutions and universities. You can search and find out about them with the help of the internet. The next is electronic or digital journalism. These are ultra-modern periodicals from a part of electronic or digital journalism. Ultra-modern. Ultra-modern means extremely modern or advanced. History is a prime subject of interest for these periodicals as well. Many web news portals, social media, web channels, YouTube, etc. make historical content available to the audience, readers. Radio. Indian Broadcasting Company, a private radio company, was the first one to broadcast daily programs. Later, the same company was taken over by the British government and named as Indian State Broadcasting Service. On 8th June 1936, it was renamed as All India Radio. After independence, All India Radio became an integral part of the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, India. Initially, it broadcasted governmental programs and schemes. It was named as Akashvani on the suggestion of the famous poet Pandit Narendra Sharma. Akashvani broadcast various entertainment, awareness, creating and literary programs. It also broadcast special programs for farmers, workers, the youth and women. The Vivid Bharati programs are broadcasted in 24 regional languages as well as 146 dialects of Indian languages.
Vivid Bharati, Manoranjan, Suchna aur Vigyapan ka ek santulit mishra hai, jiski pahunch har gaon, nagar, har ghar aangan tak hai. लगभग 23 करोड़ लोगों तक इस चैनल के रेडियो सिग्नल्स हर पल पहुंच रहे हैं। 6 करोड़ से ज्यादा घर ऐसे हैं जहां हर दिन सिर्फ इसी चैनल को सुना जाता है। विविध भारती आज पूरे एशिया में नेशनल नेटवर्किंग का सबसे विशाल रेडियो चैनल है। देश भर में फैले हुए इसके 40 ऐसे केंद्र हैं जो प्रतिदिन 16 घंटे से ज्यादा सिर्फ विविध भारती के कार्यक्रमों का प्रसारण करते हैं। इनमें से 30 केंद्र ऐसे हैं जहां विविध भारती का प्रसारण एफएम ट्रांसमीटर से किया जाता है, जिसका मतलब है क्रिस्टल क्लियर ऑडियो क्वालिटी। इसके अलावा कई प्राथमिक रेडियो केंद्र हैं जो अपनी सुविधा अनुसार दोपहर या रात को विविध भारती के कार्यक्रम प्रसारित करते हैं। और तो और, आकाशवाणी की रात्रि प्रसारण सेवा के लिए मशहूर नेशनल चैनल भी रात को 11 बजे से सुबह 6 बजे तक विविध भारती के कार्यक्रम ही प्रसारित करता है। प्रसारण की दुनिया के क्रांतिकारी बदलावों के साथ विविध भारती भी हम कदम हो आगे बढ़ रही है।
जितनी तेजी से और सब परिवर्तन होते हैं, सबसे अधिक तेज परिवर्तन होता है तकनीक में। जो हम नई टेक्नोलॉजी का इस्तेमाल करते हैं, हम अधिक से अधिक लोगों के बीच जाते हैं। आर्थिक उत्पादन में ज्यादा जॉब क्रिएशंस जैसे हुई हैं, उसी तरह से ज्यादा लोगों की सेवा के लिए एफएम टेक्नोलॉजी एक बहुत अच्छा माध्यम है, बहुत अच्छा साधन है, जिसे हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि विविध भारती को एफएम टेक्नोलॉजी पर लेकर आए। उस स्थिति में बड़े बड़े शहरों में, दिल्ली है, मुंबई है या दूसरे और बड़े शहर हैं, उसमें भी विविध भारती एफएम पर जब आपको उपलब्ध होगा तो निश्चय ही एक नई चुनौती होगी।
विविध भारती देश की वो सुरीली धड़कन है, मनोरंजन जिसका धर्म है, मधुरता जिसका मर्म है और निरंतरता जिसका कर्म है। पिछले 50 सालों से अनवरत विविध भारती इस देश के कोने कोने में, दूर दराज के अंचल में, हर मौसम में, हर पल 24 घंटे पार्श्व संगीत की तरह बज रही है। देश की रग रग में हर पल हर घड़ी गूंज रही है। सुरों का ये सुनहरा सफर निरंतर जारी रहा है, जारी रहेगा।
Lately, various news channels like Radio Mirchi are providing radio services. In the British India, the first English news bulletin was broadcasted on 23rd July 1927 from the Mumbai radio station of the Indian Broadcasting Company. Later, the Kolkata radio station of IBC started a news bulletin in Bengali. Television. The Delhi Doordarshan Center was inaugurated by Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the first Indian president. Doordarshan's Mumbai center began to telecast its programs on 1st May 1972.
विज्ञान और तकनीक ने जमाने को पूरी तरह बदल दिया है। इसी क्रम में बात करें तो सूचना और मनोरंजन के क्षेत्र में नए चैनलों की भरमार सी लगी हुई है। तरक्की के इस युग में आपने कभी नहीं सोचा होगा कि आज के चैनल जो इतना प्रसिद्ध हो चुके हैं वो हमारे बीच कैसे आए। अतीत के पन्ने पर दूरदर्शन का इतिहास टटोलते ही धुंधली सी यादें आंखों के सामने झलकने लगती है। वही धुंधली सी यादें जब पूरे देश में एक ही चैनल हुआ करता था, उसके कार्यक्रमों को हम मनोरंजन का सागर समझकर उसमें गोते लगाया करते थे। आज के जमाने में प्रसारित होने वाले चैनलों का तो आज़ादी के बाद से सन 1990 के दशक तक वजूद भी नहीं था। वजूद था तो सिर्फ एक चैनल का, और वह था दूरदर्शन। तो चलिए एक बार फिर से झांकते हैं उन पुरानी यादों में और देखते हैं कि कैसे शुरू हुआ था दूरदर्शन का सफर। विदेशों में टीवी चैनल बहुत पहले आ चुके थे, मगर भारत आने में इसने थोड़ी देर कर दी। भारत में किसी को यह पक्का नहीं पता था कि टीवी आखिर यहाँ चलेगा कि नहीं। भारत में टीवी लाया गया और साथ में ही दूरदर्शन भी शुरू किया गया। इसका पहला प्रसारण दिल्ली के शहरी इलाकों में 15 सितंबर सन 1959 को प्रयोग के तौर पर किया गया था। तब इसे हफ्ते में सिर्फ 3 दिन के लिए टीवी पर देखा जाता था, वह भी आधे आधे घंटे के लिए। अपने पहले प्रसारण से ही यह लोगों को बहुत पसंद आया और कुछ सालों के अंदर ही यह लोगों की आदत सा बन गया। 6 साल बाद 1965 में इसका प्रसारण रोजाना किया जाने लगा। यूनेस्को ने इसके लिए भारत को $20,000 और 180 फिलिप्स के टेलीविज़न सेट दिए। इसके बाद हर रोज 5 मिनट के लिए समाचार का बुलेटिन प्रसारित किया जाने लगा। शुरू के समय में दूरदर्शन का नाम टेलीविज़न इंडिया हुआ करता था। सन 1975 में इसका नाम बदलकर दूरदर्शन रख दिया गया। शुरुआत में दूरदर्शन को सिर्फ 7 शहरों में ही दिखाया गया। उन दिनों दिल्ली में एक बड़ा ट्रांसमीटर लगाया गया था जिससे दूरदर्शन का प्रसारण होता था। साथ ही इसका प्रसारण देखने के लिए अलग अलग जगहों पर 18 टेलीविज़न सेट लगाए गए। तब लोगों को यह समझ नहीं आ रहा था कि यह क्या है और क्यों लगाया गया है, क्योंकि इसके पहले इतनी अद्भुत चीज़ उन्होंने कभी नहीं देखी थी। इस चैनल पर सन 1966 में पहली बार कृषि दर्शन कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत की गई। कृषि प्रधान देश होने के नाते इस कार्यक्रम ने ग्रामीण क्षेत्रों में अपना झंडा गाड़ दिया। किसानों के बीच यह काफी लोकप्रिय हो गया। शायद यह जानकर आपको आश्चर्य हो कि आज भी यह कार्यक्रम दूरदर्शन पर सबसे अधिक दिनों तक चलने वाला सबसे पुराना कार्यक्रम है। शुरुआती समय में दूरदर्शन की चाल धीमी रही, पर जैसे जैसे समय बीता यह धीरे धीरे बुलंदियों की कहानी लिखने लगा। 80 के दशक में इस चैनल को भारत के सभी शहरों में प्रसारित किया जाने लगा। 15 अगस्त सन 1982 में तत्कालीन प्रधानमंत्री इंदिरा गांधी के भाषण के समय पहली बार इसका रंगीन प्रसारण किया गया। रंगीन प्रसारण देख के तो लोगों के अंदर एक और उमंग जाग गई। हर कोई टीवी का दीवाना हो गया और साथ में ही दूरदर्शन का भी। इसके बाद से ही रंगीन टेलीविजन बाजारों में आने लगे। उसी साल दिल्ली में हुए एशियाई खेलों को भी दर्शकों के बीच रंगीन स्क्रीन पर लाया गया। पूरा देश एक अनोखे मनोरंजन की दुनिया में कदम रख चुका था। एक के बाद एक विस्तार ने दूरदर्शन की काया ही पलट कर रख दी। अब दूरदर्शन ऐसे पड़ाव पर था जब लोग इस पर आने वाले कार्यक्रमों को देखने के लिए अपना जरूरी काम तक छोड़ देते थे। रविवार का दिन तो एक त्योहार के जैसा लगता था। उस दौर में गांव भर में एक टेलीविजन सेट हुआ करता था जिस पर सैकड़ों लोग कार्यक्रम को रोमांच भरी निगाहों से देखकर आनंद लिया करते थे। वह समय भी इतिहास की कहानी ही बयां करता है जब घरों के छतों पर बांस के सहारे लगाए गए एल्यूमिनियम के डंडे से टेलीविजन सेटों को सिग्नल मिलता था, जिसके घुमाए जाने पर दूरदर्शन चैनल साफ झिलमिलाहट का संकेत दिया करता था। 80 के दशक में भारत के पहले प्रसारणकर्ता दूरदर्शन का सिक्का चमकने लगा था। इस पर प्रसारित किए जाने वाले कार्यक्रमों ने पूरे भारत में तहलका मचा दिया। हम लोग नाम के कार्यक्रम ने ऐसी छाप छोड़ी कि उस दौर से गुजरने वाले लोग आज भी उस पल को भुला नहीं सके हैं। इसके बाद बुनियाद, चित्रहार, सुबह सवेरे, रामायण, श्री कृष्ण, महाभारत, मालगुडी डेज, वहाँ जनाब ने दूरदर्शन को जमीन से शिखर पर लाकर खड़ा कर दिया। दूरदर्शन उस समय एक ऐसा चैनल था जो अकेले ही हर चीज को दिखाता था। बच्चों से लेकर बूढ़ों तक के कार्यक्रम इस पर आया करते थे। शक्तिमान, जूनियर जी, ही मैन, व्योमकेश बख्शी, टर्निंग पॉइंट, अलीफ लैला, चंद्रकांता जैसे अन्य कार्यक्रमों ने लोगों के दिलों पर लंबे समय तक राज किया। इसी बीच दर्शकों के बढ़ते रोमांच और मांग को देखते हुए दूरदर्शन ने अपना विस्तार किया। 26 जनवरी सन 1993 को दूरदर्शन अपना दूसरा चैनल लेकर आया जिसका नाम था मेट्रो। इसके बाद पहला चैनल DD1 तथा दूसरा चैनल DD2 के नाम से लोकप्रिय हो गया। 14 नवंबर 1995 को DD इंडिया की शुरुआत हुई जो एक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय चैनल था। दर्शकों द्वारा खेल चैनल की मांग को देखते हुए दूरदर्शन ने 18 मार्च 1999 में खेल के चैनल DD स्पोर्ट्स की शुरुआत की। सांस्कृतिक चैनल DD भारती को दूरदर्शन ने 26 जनवरी 2002 में शुरू किया। इसी साल 3 नवंबर को 24 घंटे समाचार चैनल DD न्यूज का भी प्रसारण किया जाने लगा। सन 2004 में 16 दिसंबर को डायरेक्ट टू होम सेवा को दर्शकों के टेलीविजन सेट पर मुफ्त में दिखाया गया, जिसकी सेवा आज भी बरकरार है। इस तरह बदलते समय और जनता की मांग को देखते हुए दूरदर्शन ने खुद को आगे बढ़ाया। दूरदर्शन के इतने सारे चैनल हो गए थे कि घर के हर एक सदस्य के लिए उसमें कुछ न कुछ जरूर था।
कलर टेलीविजन वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड ऑन 15 अगस्त 1982। इन 1991 द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट ग्रांटेड परमिशन टू प्राइवेट नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल चैनल्स टू टेलीकास्ट इन इंडिया। Thus, it became possible for Indians to watch international events on television. The next topic is, why do we need mass media? We need mass media to facilitate free flow of information to all strata of the society. Editorials, various columns and supplements are essential parts of newspapers. Readers are also ensured of a platform to voice their opinions. Newspapers can help in making the democracy stronger. Now, the meaning of this, readers are also ensured of a platform to voice their opinions, means even the people have the full freedom, whatever they want to express their opinions, they can write in the newspaper, they can approach the editor. Television is an audiovisual medium. It was possible for this medium to cross the inherent limitations of newspapers and the radio and show the actual visuals of an event to people. So far, there is no other alternative to television for watching an event as it actually happened. The next topic is critical understanding of the information received through mass media. Any information received through mass media needs to be reviewed critically. The news or information in the media may not always represent exact truth. The news or information in the media may not always represent exact truth. We need to scan it very carefully. There is a very famous event of unauthentic information appearing in print in Germany. Stern, a German weekly magazine, had purchased a number of so-called handwritten diaries of Adolf Hitler. It sold them to various publication companies. The diaries were verified for their authenticity and subsequently the news appeared in the print. However, later those diaries were proved to be forged. It becomes apparent from this example that we need to be very careful about the information published by the media. The next topic is mass media and professional opportunities. Newspapers have to fulfill the task of providing fresh news to its readers. It is also necessary to unfold the background of an event in the news. At such times, newspapers have to resort to history. While reporting news in detail, reporters try to compare it with parallel events which happened in the past. The past event may be printed in a separate frame. Thus, the reader gets access to additional information and he can get better insights about the current news. Newspapers print columns about historical information appearing under headings such as 50 years ago or 100 years ago. Such columns are based on historical documents or written history. These columns provide historical information about economic, social, political events in the past and also events of historical significance. Newspapers also publish crossword puzzles based on history. Let us try to create similar crossword puzzles. For example, we can use folk names to create a puzzle. Newspapers occasionally publish supplements to the regular edition or special issues. For example, World War I commenced in 1914. Commenced means it started or it began in the year 1914. Year 2014 marked the 100th year of this event. In order to be able to publish a newspaper supplement or a special issue to commemorate the occasion, one needs to review its history. In 2017, 75 years were completed after the announcement of Quit India Movement. On such occasions, newspapers highlight the event through various articles, editorials, columns like what happened in history on this day, reviews, etc. The knowledge of history is essential for writings of such type. Now let us try to do this. Try to collect information about the role of underground radio centers in the Quit India Movement of 1942. Now, we have learned about Quit India Movement in the lower classes in Standard 8. So, you can find out information about the role played by the underground radio centers in the Quit India Movement with the help of the internet. History is also essential in planning radio programs. For example, Akashvani has preserved recordings of all the speeches delivered each year by the Prime Ministers of India on 15th August. Akashvani invites historians as experts for discussions on various occasions such as the anniversaries of birth or death of national leaders, anniversaries of historical events, etc. Lectures on the contribution of various national leaders need to be supported by historical information. Programs like On This Day in History are also an integral part of the daily programs of Akashvani. Television channels also telecast programs based on history. Doordarshan and other television channels help in creating interest in history among people through the historical shows and serials. The mythological and historical serials like Ramayana, Mahabharata, Bharat Ek Khoj and Raja Shiv Chhatrapati attracted a very large audience. While producing this type of programs, maintaining accuracy with regard to the presentation of environment, outfits, weaponry, lifestyles, lingual expression, etc. is essential. One needs to have a deep understanding of history of the concerned period. Currently, channels like Discovery, National Geographic, History, etc. have opened a rich treasure of global history for the audience. It has enabled people to view the historical and geographic wonders.
Figs will have to do. Peace is again restored to the forest canopy.
To make such programs more entertaining, some parts of the serial are actually enacted by actors, such as the characters of heroic men and women, sportsmen, army chiefs, etc. Besides these serials about ancient monuments, forts, histories of empires, and also the history of culinary arts are watched by a large number of people with great interest. People with deep knowledge of history in the respective fields are sought out in all the fields mentioned above. Let us say this passage given here. Bharat Ek Khoj. This was a serial telecast by Doordarshan, which had a special place in the history of Indian television series. It was based on Discovery of India. Now, Discovery of India is a book written by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of independent India. It was directed by Shyam Benigal. This serial presented the history of India from the ancient to the modern period, throwing light on social, cultural and political history of respective periods. It effectively portrayed many aspects of Indian history like Harappan civilization, Vedic history, interpretation of Ramayana and Mahabharata, Maurya period, Turk-Afghan inventions, Mughal period and the contributions of Mughal emperors, Bhakti movement, role of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, movements of social reform and Indian struggle for independence, etc. Now in this serial, Roshan Sheth, the actor who played Pandit Nehru's role, also appeared as a narrator, introducing and explaining various parts of the story by dramatizing them using folklore and informative speeches. The serial was admired in all parts of India because of the comprehensive historical perspective of Pandit Nehru and its equally comprehensive visual presentation.
Akbar ke baad, uski Rajput Rani Jodhabai ka beta Jahangir gaddi par baitha. उसने कुछ हद तक अपने पिता की परंपरा को आगे बढ़ाया, लेकिन शायद उसे राजकाज से ज्यादा दिलचस्पी थी चित्रकारी और कला में, फूलों और बगीचों में. उस समय हिंदुस्तान का आर्थिक पसमंदर क्या था? हिंदुस्तान एक बहुत तरक्की याफ्ता मुल्क था, जहां का बना माल बाहरी मुल्कों को निर्यात होता था.